In the winter of 2022, archaeologists from Archaeological Management Solutions investigated the N77 Ballyragget Village to Ballynaslee Road Improvement Scheme on behalf of Kilkenny County Council. This is a process that happens in advance of construction of all national road projects in Ireland. The archaeological works were overseen by archaeologists from Transport Infrastructure Ireland and were carried out by John Channing under licences issued by the National Monument Service of the Department of Housing, Local Government and Heritage. Six sites were identified through a combination of historical research, remote sensing and archaeological test trenching. These were then excavated and recorded in the spring of 2023. Test excavations help to identify undocumented sites that have no surface expression. It is one of the methods used in an evolving investigation process, the aim of which is to ensure strategies are put in place to lessen the archaeological impact of the development. Test trenches were excavated within the footprint of the project and placed to target areas of interest, highlighted in earlier research. The trenches totaled a length of 3,665 metres, or 13.5% of the area available for testing. The trenches were excavated by a machine with a wide toothless bucket in layers or spits down to subsoil. Any features of archaeological interest were manually tested and recorded. Ballyconra 1 consisted of two 19th century structures approximately 15 metres apart. The southern structure comprised two main rooms with two additional rooms added to the northern and southern ends. An external cobbled yard was identified to the west. The smaller northern structure also consisted of two rooms. A large pit within the eastern room was later backfilled with modern debris. Earlier activity, predating the two-room structure, was present in the form of cobbled surfaces. The presence of a dress stone in the northwest corner is an example of the reuse of materials, which was common practice in 19th century Ireland. The stone is rectangular and dressed on three of the four long faces, suggesting it was previously part of a projecting architectural pillar or moulding. Ballyconra 2, 3 and 4 evidenced an earlier pattern of cultivation and field division. The linear ditches uncovered at all three sites were interpreted as field boundaries. These suggest an earlier relict field pattern that followed a slightly different form to the current layout and may reflect late medieval settlement in the area. The site of Ballyconra 2 consisted of two linear ditches, a possible pit, agricultural furrows, and a geological anomaly. Ballyconra 3 consisted of two linear boundaries together with agricultural features, while Ballyconra 4 consisted of an east-west orientated boundary ditch, agricultural furrows, and a second linear ditch orientated north-south. An isolated feature resembling a kiln in plan was located in the northeast of the cutting centre of Ballyconra 3. Ballyconra 5 consisted of a possible gate lodge to Ballyconra Mill and Hall and an associated cluster of buildings recorded on historical mapping. The mill and hall were an 18th century flour mill and adjacent residence that are no longer standing. Excavations revealed five main phases of development, comprising phase 1, building to northeast of site, and boundary wall running along the west side, both recorded on first edition 6-inch map. A paved stone floor within the footprint of a later phase 3 building probably relates to a rectangular structure recorded on the first edition map. This map was surveyed in 1838. Phase 2 comprised a two-roomed gate lodge with hipped roof fronting onto lane. Phase 3 saw a northern extension to the gate lodge, creating additional room with annex to the west. Phase 4, a further extension to the north of the gate lodge, along with internal remodelling within the Phase 3 extension and a northern extension to the northeast building. Phase 5 sees additional outbuildings and remodelling of existing structures with the inset of larger window openings and new lintels and sills. The western annex and alcoves within the gate lodge are blocked off. Three layers of plaster were revealed on the internal walls of the Phase 2 gate lodge, with the earliest layers containing evidence of animal hair. The hipped roof used glazed ridge tiles made at Bridgewater in England. Floor surfaces varied from flag floors to wood or clay. The earliest floor deposits relate to an earlier structure on the site, recorded on the first edition Ordnance Survey 6-inch map. Finds from Ballyconra 5 include a Henschel-type corkscrew, named after the Reverend Samuel Henschel, who patented the design in 1795. It is tempting to speculate that the find found its way from a table in the big house nearby, i.e. Ballyconra House, as previously in 1767, two servants at Ballyconra House, once the home of Viscount MacGarrett, Earl of Kilkenny, were convicted of disposing of a large part of furniture while his lordship was in France. A different flavour of 19th century life at Ballyconra is reflected in the biography of Mabel Cahill, who grew up at Ballyconra House. Mabel was introduced to tennis by her family and began playing on a small court on the grounds. In 1884, at the age of 21, Mabel Cahill won the singles and doubles titles at the US National Championships, now known as the US Open. This achievement made her the first foreign-born woman to claim a major tennis tournament in the United States and the only Irish person to enter the Tennis Hall of Fame. Ballyconra 6 consisted of a vernacular two-bay single-story building with double-pitched roof of corrugated iron and extensions to the east and west. The house was built against a field bank on the edge of a narrow lane, identified as Butler's Lane by the locals. Excavations revealed a cobbled yard at the eastern extent with an earlier cobbled lair beneath. A partial flag floor was identified below a concrete floor within the eastern extension. The sequence of construction and reconstruction revealed during the excavation suggests fluctuations in the local economy over time. It is possible that the settlement experienced a period of abandonment and partial collapse following the Great Famine, or the decline of the local milling industry following a fire at Ballyconra Mill in 1885. Fragments of a perforated kiln tile, most likely derived from a nearby maltings, were found within the hearths at the three cottage sites investigated. Outreach was performed throughout the archaeological excavations. Some 35 to 40 people attended our open day at Ballyconra 1, where John Channing, site director, and Colm Hardy, senior archaeologist, gave site tours. Staff at Archaeological Management Solutions were on hand to discuss historical documents relating to the project and the artifacts that were recovered during the excavations. The community recounted local folklore and provided details on vernacular buildings and their inhabitants. This greatly helped to flesh out the excavation results. John Channing and Colm Hardy also visited Lisdowney National School to meet the children of 5th and 6th class and highlight the discoveries of the scheme, the role of an archaeologist, and the importance of heritage in the local community. Our thanks to the local community, landowners, AMS staff, Kilkenny County Council, and TIA project archaeologist Bernice Kelly.